Oh, wow.
Nah. This shouldn't be legal.
This is a walk-in closet.
$1,000 a month.
I mean,
you've got to be kidding me. What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Today's reaction video is inside the smallest apartments in New York City. Now, we did a reaction not too long ago about what you could get for $1 million and $500,000 around the US. New York came up in both, and it's not much. For that insane amount of money, which it is really an insane amount of money, you can hardly get anything. And as being an architect myself, I do live in Jersey, which is the upper end price-wise of England. You've kind of got London in England, and then if you go to the Channel Islands, you've kind of got Jersey just below it, I'd say. And then the further north you get in England, a lot cheaper it gets. Like, it is mad cheap over there compared. So it's going to be interesting to see like how small they are, because it's going to put into perspective, because you have some small places over here, which we think cost a fortune. But I imagine in New York, they are tiny and cost the absolute dollar. We'll see. I get why. It's everyone crammed into a small space. People want to be there. You know what I mean? It's a city that never sleeps. But sometimes, man, it's just not worth it. Let me know your thoughts in the comments. Let's get straight into it. Inside the smallest apartments in New York City. Let me know in the comments if you want me to react to stuff like this in the future. Maybe other cities and stuff like that. I definitely will do. And subscribe if you're new. I'd seriously appreciate that. Let's check it out. Inside the smallest apartments in New York City. What we got?
All right, Ennis, what are we doing today? Do you even know what we're doing today?
I have no idea. You told me to dress up.
I have a little day plan for you. Actually, there's a coffee shop over here. Let's go get a coffee and I'll fill you in. We have a guy on the way. He's a realtor.
Okay.
He specializes in micro apartments.
Okay.
Yeah, when you've got a realtor who specializes in micro apartments, that's when you know there's too many tiny apartments, and we've got someone who specializes in it. That is mental.
We're going to be looking at some of the smallest apartments in Manhattan today.
You're kidding,
Under 300 square feet.
Oh, wow.
Wait, I need to convert that. We'll give the channel a like as well. Like this channel, I'd appreciate it. And we'll subscribe, because I haven't checked this channel out before. I should know the conversion, because we do it at work all the time. But I don't know it off the top of my head. I know, what was it? 300 square foot. I work in square meters a lot. Oh, my. 27 square meters. Again, I knew it weren't much. And I should have really known that, because we kind of worked at least where I work, we kind of worked at 52 square meters as the lowest of the low for a one bed apartment. That's what we personally do. And we do like the size you need to get. So you can't really get too much smaller than that. Again, we mix it up, but that is like kind of like the minimum 52. So the fact that you're going 27 square meters, that is insane. Wow.
Let's see what happens.
You guys saved me a spot right in the front. I've got a couple places. Once you see them, you can't unsee them.
I'm getting two of these. If you want, I'll get you one.
No, I'm good. Three biscotti. I'll get a cranberry. What's up, guys? I'm Cash Jordan, and I've been a rental agent here in New York City for 12 years. Today, okay, we're going to see some apartments. See this? This is how much space you're going
to
get.
I don't know what to get. I'm just here to observe and enjoy. But yeah, we're about to see some crazy places, I guess.
What's up, Ben? Jesus.
Nice
I
you.
See you on Instagram all the time.
Cool, man.
That's hilarious.
That's
I
great.
Just walking by.
Dude, that's like, so funny.
Yeah, man. You're doing a good job.
I appreciate that.
Definitely, man.
Thank you. Merry Christmas.
Dude. No love for Ennis.
Yeah, Cash is killing it over here. Shout out to Cash in New York.
All right, where are we starting?
I am also trying to spot out, by the way, because you guys, if you're viewing the channel, you know I have been to New York. The only place I've been into America, I know I need to explore, because it's a completely different experience. Before I get them comments, I am trying to spot if I notice anything, because we did do a lot. I haven't really spotted anything yet. I feel like we're on the back streets, not really in Times Square area, where we mainly work, because we were tourists at the end of the day. But I am trying to spot that as well.
The cheapest place we have, and the smallest.
And
ready? Let's go.
What?
Pretty interesting building. It's got security cameras. They've done what they could to make the hallway better. I think it's actually pretty good for this neighborhood. Let's head upstairs.
Hey,
how's it going?
Hey.
I mean, I'm kind of
stuck on the hallway.
But these are the bathrooms.
Okay. No shower.
No
I mean, corridors, they don't even look 800. What? It is super, super tight. When I say 800, I mean millimeters. Again, probably different units to what you guys use. It's looking tight,
but
man.
These
that
are
toilet.
The bathrooms.
Oh, my okay. days.
No shower.
No, that's right here. They're half baths.
Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Let me go in there.
Just like a good old exterior door to seal it off.
Yo, take us in.
It's like college.
Oh my god, what? I thought there was a wraparound. I was like, take us in, I want to see. No, that's literally it. Oh yeah. My days.
Are you serious?
Oh, wow.
Nah. This shouldn't be legal.
This is a walk-in closet.
$1,000 a month.
I mean,
you gotta be kidding
good.
Me.
So, you got a little, I guess, vanity slash, hey, it
yeah.
drains, so it's your sink kind of
yep.
setup here.
Yep,
you can live. How would you frame this? I'm assuming this is kind of like your loft. You put the bed up here.
So, what most people probably would do is, a loft isn't for everyone, because, you know, if you have to use the restroom,
it's not
practical.
Yeah.
And, I mean, this is a fun neighborhood with, we're by a bunch of colleges.
Uh-huh.
We're surrounded by bars and restaurants and fun things to do. If you're out having a good time, you might not be able to climb down from there.
I love how polite he explained that. Basically, if you're drunk, you may, you know, knock yourself out. So
I've heard that drinking's not the only thing that people do in the East
Village.
That's what I've heard. I don't know. That's what I've heard.
There's so many things I want to ask you.
That's okay.
So that's kind of like your loft space. You share the bathrooms. Where's the kitchen? There's a kitchen.
Oh, he's gonna tell us that microwave and bloody fridge and that 500 mil of worktop is gonna be, oh, I can't. All right, this is honestly just making me cringe. The fact that people are paying potentially $1,000 to live in something like this a month. Oh, it should not be legal, man. I completely understand they don't have much space and all that, but surely, man, this can't be legal. It's mate, if you do live in something like this, please let me know in the comments. I'm not trying to bash your lifestyle or anything like that. I just, surely, let me know your experience if anyone is living in something like this. Maybe you absolutely love it. Maybe you just don't need much space. Maybe you just like being outside. You don't have to spend much time in your house, but... Oh, man. Wow.
This is your oven, and it is your microwave.
Mikey, you gotta move the camera for that.
Yeah.
So this is all you get.
Oh, it's not even a worktop, it's a bloody sink. Oh my god.
That's what you get. It's technically all you need.
You know what, like, I'm gonna say this, and I know Mikey can relate to it because we've kind of gone through it in our work process. Sometimes when your resources are limited, it pushes you to become creative.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
I kind of feel like this, like, in a way, if I moved in here in a month, I'd be like, this is actually not too bad. I found this restaurant that I can microwave, it's affordable, and then I just, you know, I feel like
I don't know about that.
Get into the groove. How big is this? Like, what is the square footage, or like, can we get the measurements of the walls and openings?
Yeah, we could find out how big it is.
Okay.
11 feet, 1 inch. All right, but let's get the
real
what people want.
So we got 10,790.
Wow.
So do the math, how many square feet?
So it's almost 11 by 11,
mm-hmm.
right?
Yep.
That's
but you have to subtract.
Oh my god!
You have to subtract some of what you can't use, right?
Yeah.
Like this kind of comes out.
Dude, this is 120 square feet.
Well, it's less usable because of like.
I guess there's no way you can get smaller than that, Matt. I'm honestly in pain watching this. I really am.
Doesn't have anything that you'd probably... Well, I shouldn't say that. It has its own bathroom. It has its own kitchen. Two things that we couldn't find in the other apartment. And the rent here is $500 more a month. So a 50% increase for the other 50% of the apartment.
Okay.
Fair, right? It sounds fair.
Pretty straightforward.
Let's check it out.
Honestly, this feels like an apartment in a central location in Turkey. It kind of has that old marble, wider staircase. I'm digging it.
I was like, you better not go over more flights.
I mean, as well, right? Does a building not have a lift? I imagine it can't have a lift. Like, if you were doing this YouTube video, you'd just take the lift if it did. And the fact that you're paying that much for a flat, which is going to be super small, and you have to walk up all them stairs, man, like, come on.
Can't. We're at the top. Look, we're there.
Oh. How's this?
No.
Hold on. It's...
Oh,
you ready?
Okay.
Key to the city. Hey.
Yo. Teaching people bad habits right there.
Wow. Cash has a darkest skill set too.
Oh, wow.
A little bit bigger, okay.
Now we are talking.
Dude. That's not that bad compared.
No, this is fine.
This is fine.
This is awesome. So for $1,500, this is the cheapest place in the entire neighborhood.
Rated out of, you know, 1 out of 10, considering the other $1,500 option.
Everything's a 10 out of 10 for the right person. That's why they signed the lease. If you want to spend $1,500 and you want something bigger, you want something maybe a little bit more modern, that 10 out of 10 might be in another part of the city, right? But
you know what? That is a great motto. Everything's a 10 out of 10 if it fits the person's needs. If you don't care about space, you just want to be in New York, you've got a job there, the Big Apple, the city that never sleeps. It is your 10 out of 10. It gets you by. You know what I mean? It's not as bad as you are. I'm not as cringing as much. It is tiny and it shouldn't still be a thing. But that last one was pathetic. It really was.
But for this part of the city, if location, proximity to things in like a clean place, which is well-based, then it becomes a 10 out of 10.
I hear you. Well,
I get
said.
That.
Cool. Well said. I mean, this is definitely spacious. I do not feel cramped here at all. Got the massive window, you get a little view.
It's a good view.
Take us on the tour.
Kitchen.
Nice.
Living room. No. Let me show you the bedroom.
Okay. Yeah, I guess
the
that's
bedroom's the best part. Look, it's good.
Yeah, bedroom is an all right size.
Oh, this is great.
Now the complaint that a lot of people are gonna have is that this radiator is in the wrong place, right? You'd think that this should be in the corner. But if you say, if you're gonna put up with this, right over there, home office, bed and everything else over here. It divides the room.
That's character, dude. I like that.
Maybe it makes...
Why the hell? Please let me know, McCoy. It can't be an American thing. It must, like they were just saying. Who designs it and go, I'm going to put a radiator in front of that window? I'm not going to put... Because I completely get it. You kind of put radiators underneath a window because that's when you get the heat source. You know what I mean? That's where the heat is most likely to escape when a window's open. You might just want some fresh air. It may be freezing cold and the heat's going to escape. So you just attack the cold air coming in at the source. Heat's a route. I completely understand that. But they've just decided to put a tall rad in there, which just blocks the window. Oh, this video hurts me, man.
It makes more sense to use this as like a two-room studio. You have everything, bed, hangout stuff in here. You've got the... This is a good... For the East Village, this is a great view.
I mean, the fact that you're getting a view is,
better than nothing.
I thought you were going to take us somewhere like dingy, first floor. No, this is like nice and bright. Leave these windows open, get some fresh air.
So you've got your own kitchen, which we looked at, which is great. Didn't have that before. And then you have your own bathroom.
Let's see you NSCO Mazda.
I mean, Mikey, you know, I will,
hey, give him
I will
the last.
Sell this bathroom if I need to. But first of all, you got tile floors. You got your toilet set up. Let's not forget to get your ventilation here, right? It's a functioning window. It's a big deal. Then you get a full tub set up here. First off, the shower head. Mikey, let's get a close up. It's actually a good height. I say that because a lot of times these are so low. You have to like shower like this.
Yeah.
It's actually a good height.
And you have.
That sounds like tall people problems. I'm just glad I'm medium height.
Good New York City water pressure.
Exactly, that's right. And you get a little vanity set up here. Two soap holders, you're winning.
Yeah.
Honestly, this apartment feels...
Send it to me, man.
You'll sleep on the medicine cabinet too.
Hey, look, Mikey. I mean...
You're missing details.
Soon, Mikey, I don't even need to be in front of camera. Yeah. I'm just gonna let you do this.
Cash, I think there's only one thing left to do.
Upgrade?
The laser test.
The laser, what do you want to measure?
What do we got? We got focus 9.5 by 14.6. 9.5 by 14.6.
This
good.
So this is bigger than the entire apartment we were in first.
Yep.
Yeah.
And it feels is. Like it. And again, you live in New York for New York. You don't live in New York for an apartment. Like, this is your space, gets the job done. You go out and you live your life.
That's it. Like, every single New York City apartment is overpriced unless you're here for the city. Not for the apartment.
Let's see an upgrade.
Upgrade?
Yeah.
All right, cool. Let's go.
Okay, we're going to get bigger, which is nice. It's a grand extra though. Like, you're talking 2.5 grand, even in Jersey, right? Which, again, I've said is kind of like the most expensive. Not the most expensive, but it's the upper end of compared to England and stuff like that. Whereas the North, if 2.5 grand a month in the North, you're thinking cinema rooms, probably everything, and it is stunning. In Jersey, you're probably thinking a very nice house. Like, a very, very nice house. A 3-bedroom, I'd guess. I don't know. I've never really looked at renting a house, to be honest with you, at 2.5. I'm more, because I'm in construction, we build a house to sell it. That's what we do. We build apartments to sell them. So I don't know, really. I'm not amazing at the renting prices, but I guess you could get a very nice house for 2.5 grand a month, to be honest with you, over here. The fact that you're going on to the next upgrade on that flat, ridiculous.
Dude, this has like 2 living rooms, I guess.
The point of comparison for this shouldn't be the place that we just looked at upstairs. It should be the first place we saw, because that per person is actually cheaper than this. It's a $2,500 apartment.
Yeah.
It's a 2-bedroom. The rooms are about the same size.
Mm-hmm.
So you're paying $1,250 for this. Is this better or worse? This is something for you to decide. Is this better or worse than what we just looked at, sharing a bathroom but getting an entire place that's yours?
What is the status with the washer and dryer?
You know, it exists in a laundromat, which is on Google Maps.
Okay, all right. Didn't see that coming. Mikey, let's show the size of this room.
I think for scale, we need to pull out that laser one more time.
All right, yeah. See, it's a good thing I shouldn't have brought it. No, it's a good thing I did. If I didn't, this would be tough. Here we go.
6 feet, 11 inches by 10.5.
Okay.
Or 10 feet, 5 inches.
Let's check the other room.
10 feet, 5 inches by 6 feet, 10 inches.
If it was a cannon, you'd never focus.
Wow. So, Ennis, your thoughts?
I mean, first one is a reality check to me. It's like,
I guess we gotta see the kitchen before we can get there.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah. This is fine.
This is fine.
I mean, I don't mind it. For 2.5 grand, it's ridiculous, you know what I mean? But I don't mind it. It's compared to that first one, way better. It's just a complete upgrade on the first one, obviously. Even if you're sharing with somebody, you've got your own room, way better. But it's ridiculous price.
And check this out. Come over here. If you injure yourself in the kitchen, you don't have to go to a hospital, man.
Good.
Bro, look at this. By what's missing, you can tell what types of injuries the person who put this here experienced. Look, their knuckles, look at this. Their knuckles are done. They might not even have knuckles.
Something with the knuckles.
I'm assuming they haven't been burned very often.
So,
and they don't have any infections, but knuckles, that's gone.
So, Cash, I found you yesterday on Instagram, and you said that people in New York will throw in these little things to kind of pad the price of the unit. Is this one of those features, the first aid kit?
I don't think any landlord in their right mind would put that in there and tell you that it means don't kill us.
Yeah, I will.
So we have a first aid kit.
Well, that's the burn stuff is still in there. We're good.
Wow.
So bathroom. Well, last test. And then
bathroom is upgraded. I mean, I kind of got it. Honestly, this bathroom is pretty
good. Nice. It's got a bit of a feature. Have a shower as well. The feature tiling. I like that. You know.
New tile, new tub setup, getting your vanity.
Yeah.
Okay, no, it's not a feature. It's not really a feature. I thought it was different tiling at first glance. But still, it's fully tiled. Not tiled when it doesn't need to be. Fair play. It's not a bad bathroom, to be fair.
It ain't floating vanity, but
who needs that, though?
Who needs that in New York?
So, final thoughts. 1, 2, 3. Ennis and then Cash.
I think first one is a reality check and price you pay to live in New York. That's really it.
Yeah.
And then, but I can see the practical purpose behind like why people choose that. I honestly think the second and third one is plenty good. Like me and Mikey are looking around constantly like, yeah, that's plenty good. Like I can see 2 roommates living here, no problem.
Yeah.
Being in the heart of the city.
Yeah.
It's certainly expensive, it's not cheap, but you don't come to New York with mediocre goals. Like you come to New York to make something out of yourself, and it's an ambitious city, so you have to live up to that. And this is the price to pay for it.
That's it. I mean, the first place shows you the difference between like what you get if you want to pay the premium, even though it's the cheapest place, that's the premium you pay for having your own apartment, right? And that's something any renter should understand. You're always going to get more if you have a roommate. I mean, here, yes, per room it's a little bit more, but you have a common space, you have a kitchen, you have a bathroom. If you don't want any of that stuff, there is a tax on being alone in your own place, no matter where it is.
That wraps up, I guess?
Yeah.
Thank you, Mikey, for thinking of this. This is a bit of a surprise. Thank you, Cash, for showing us these 3 places.
Well, we'll leave it there. That pretty much is the end of the video. These guys' links will be in the description. The link to this video where you can then get their links. I've really enjoyed that. Again, it is very eye-opening. I knew they'd be small. That first one is just absolutely mind, but I still can't get my head around it, as you guys could probably tell from the reaction. I want to know your thoughts on that first one. Would you ever live in that? Let me know in the comments below. I'd certainly appreciate that. Hit that like button if you enjoyed this video. Let me know if you want me to react to anything similar. And I will see you, legends, in the next one. Peace.